From Television City in Hollywood. The Jack Benny Program with Jack's special guests, Natalie Wood and Robert Wagner, brought to you by new Pink Lotion Lux Liquid, the liquid that's both mild to hands and hard-working in the dishpan. And a new Lux Beauty Soap with a wonderful skin purifier added to help your complexion look beautifully clear.
Did you hear the wonderful news about New Lux?
New Lux actually helps prevent skin blemishes. It's marvelous. Yes, everybody's talking about wonderful New Lux. Now you can actually purify with Lux as you beautify with Lux. Because a gentle but marvelously effective new skin purifier has been added to Lux. Just think. Now, every time you wash or bathe with New Lux, you're actually helping to purify your skin. Purify away complexion troublemakers. Purify your skin to look so much fresher, so much clearer. And new cream-enriched Lux helps keep you smoother all over. Hollywood's most beautiful stars say they love new Lux with its gentle but marvelously effective skin purifier. Discover new Lux for yourself. New Lux purifies as it beautifies.
Mr. Elliott's office. No, I'm sorry. Mr. Elliott won't be able to see you tomorrow. He's flying to New York for a meeting with Mr. Paley. Thank you.
Look. Look, miss, I've been waiting for Mr. Elliott here for over 20 minutes, and I'm a pretty busy man.
I'm sorry. I told him it was important. He said he'd be with you in just one moment.
Every time I come up here, it's the same thing. Just one moment. Just one moment. Well, the next time I come up here, I don't want to be kept waiting.
Well, I won't be able to do anything about that, because today is my last day on this job.
Oh, you're not going to work here anymore?
That's right.
Well, then I've got news for you. You're very lucky. I wouldn't say this if you weren't leaving, but your boss, Mr. Elliott, is the most overbearing smart aleck that I've ever known. I have to do business with him, otherwise I'd hate him. By the way, I hope you won't have a problem when you leave here finding another job.
Oh, I won't be looking for another job.
You won't?
No, I'm marrying Mr. Elliott.
Oh.
I'll tell the overbearing smart aleck you're still here.
Yes?
Mr. Benny is still waiting. He seems to be getting impatient.
Oh, well, see if you can stall him a few minutes more. Well, come in, come in.
What's up, Bill? You pulled us out of a production meeting. What's wrong?
Jack Benny's in the outer office.
Oh, no. What's it going to be this time? Why? What are you worried about?
You're new here. Every time Benny comes to this office, he makes another ridiculous demand.
Well, after all, he is a big star, and we're supposed to keep him happy.
Yes, but how far can you go? We've already painted the studio blue to match his eyes.
Yes, and we've even put a rocking chair in his dressing room.
Yeah. I wonder what he wants this time.
Well, there's no sense waiting. He's out there. We're going to have to see him.
I suppose you're right. Send in Mr. Benny. Say, boys, if he gets too tough, we can threaten to take away one of his makeup men.
Certainly. We'll make him get along with three. Now, wait a minute. You mean Benny needs three makeup men?
Are you kidding? He used two when he was in radio.
You can go in now.
Oh, thank you.
Well, hello, Jack.
Hello, Mr. Elliott.
Come right in. You know Mr. Thomas over there.
How are you, Mr. Thomas?
This is Jim Shuttleworth. He's new here.
How do you do?
Jack, I'm sorry I kept you waiting, but sit down and tell us what's on your mind.
Well, obviously you three gentlemen are busy, so I'll get right down to the point. Mr. Elliott, how long have I been with CBS?
Well, I should say...
I'll tell you. 12 years.
12 years. Yeah. How time flies.
Yeah. Gee, you know, when I first came to work here, you didn't have a gray hair in your head.
Well,
But in the 12 years that I've been with CBS, I've been working as an entertainer, right?
That's right. Very good, too.
Well, thank you. Thank you. But I feel that I've come to a point now in my career where I'd like to broaden out a little bit. You know, make use of all of my talents.
Well, that's only natural, Jack. What would you like to do?
Well, I think that besides starring in my own show, I'd also like to direct it.
Oh, come now, Jack. What's really on your mind?
Well, now, wait a minute. I'm serious. I'm not kidding. I mean, I don't want to be just a comedian. I want to be a director.
But, Jack, you're so busy performing on your show. Why should you take on the responsibilities of a director, too? It's not easy to act and direct at the same time.
Oh, I don't know. Marlon Brando does it.
All right, Jack. Marlon Brando does it. But I don't think...
Mr. Elliot, I'm not interested in what you think. I have a contract that states that I can direct a CBS show anytime I feel that I'm ready. And I am ready.
Yes, but look, Marlon, I will admit that legally CBS has given you the right to become a director. But surely you're not going to hold us to it.
Oh, yes, I am.
But, Jack, you...
Look, Bill, how do we know? He might turn out to be a fine director. And anyway, it isn't as though he wants to direct Playhouse 90. If he wants to direct his own show, let him.
Lady, you know, I think you're right. Okay, Jack, go ahead. Direct your own show.
Well, thank you, Miss Elliot. Thank you very, very much. Gentlemen, thank you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye. How could you let him get away with a thing like that?
Now, look, Jack is an intelligent man. Sure, he's a little enthusiastic now, but when he thinks it over, I'm sure that he'll realize it's all wrong. And he'll drop it. Believe me, if I know Benny, he'll do nothing to hurt his own show.
I hope not.
Gentlemen.
Yes, Jack?
After I left your office, I thought about it. I've changed my mind. I don't think it would be right for me to direct my own show.
You see? You see?
So instead of that, I've decided to direct Playhouse 90.
But, Jack, you brought it up. You would mention Playhouse 90. You and your big mouth.
Don't stop, Mr. Ryan. No, don't stop me. I deserve it. I'm still free.
Well, we'll see the new director in action in just a minute. But first, I'd like to direct your attention to some of the differences between dishwashing liquids. For example, here's one that's mild enough for hands but doesn't clean dishes the way you'd like. Here's another that's all right for dishes but not mild enough for hands. Believe me, neither one of them gives you the double advantage you get with new Pink Lotion Lux Liquid. I say double advantage because new Pink Lotion Lux Liquid is both mild to hands and hard-working in the dishpan. How can this be? Well, Lever research scientists have discovered a selective formula that works hard against hard surfaces like dishes and glasses, and yet is so gentle, your hands don't even know it's there. So, if you want your dishes to have a diamond sparkle and your hands to be lotion lovely, be sure you get new Pink Lotion Lux Liquid directly. Now, let's go next door to Studio 43, where Playhouse 90 is in rehearsal.
Howard, look, what's holding up a rehearsal?
Benny isn't here yet.
Oh. Well, in the meantime, can we put the kids through the musical number?
Yeah, I guess so.
All right.
Miss Wood, Mr. Wagner.
Right here.
Waiting for Mr. Benny. Would you two mind running through the number you have in the second act?
Sure, we'd be glad to.
I hope I can remember it.
Just do it the best you can. I want to get it down for time.
Okay.
Okay, Charlie. Music.
Mr.
Everybody, take five. We'll continue just as soon as Mr. Benny gets here.
You know, I still can't get over Jack Benny directing a dramatic play.
Well, you know, R.J., might be very good. After all, if I remember correctly, didn't Jack direct The Horn Blows at Midnight?
No, no, honey. He didn't direct The Horn Blows at Midnight. He was in it.
Oh. Well, who directed it?
I did. Well, I'm sure that if CBS assigned Jack to direct this production, they must know what they're doing.
Oh, well, of course. Of course they do.
All right, everybody. Here comes Mr. Benny.
Hello, everybody. I'm sorry I'm late, but you know what these conferences are.
Benny, these script changes, have you seen them?
Seen them? I made them. Now, everybody, before we get... Oh, Bob, how are you?
Hello, John.
How are you, Bob? And Natalie, sweetheart. Now, so nice to have you with us. Now, I think we have a very, very good script, so we might as well get started with the rehearsal, right? May I have my chair, please?
Where did they get that chair?
They took it out of his dressing room.
If they put a shawl on him, he'd look like Whistler's mother.
We'll take that very first scene. And, oh, I think before we do, we ought to get the idea. We ought to sort of try to remember this a little. Now, this scene is where you have just finished doing your act. Remember? In Chicago, mm-hmm. You see? So you're all alone in your hotel room waiting for word from a New York producer. And you're very, very nervous. Mm-hmm. You remember that?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, right over here. Okay, we'll take it from the start of the scene. You know where the scene starts.
Yeah.
Action.
Why don't we hear from him? Why? Why?
Well, honey, it's only 9:30. Don't be so impatient.
Just waiting. It means so much to me.
When that telegram comes, I mean we'll be headed for the big time. We'll be Broadway bound.
I hope you're right.
Hold it a minute. Who's making all that noise?
It's your rocking chair.
Oh, Miss Schultz, will you please, will you please see that there's... Miss Schultz, will you please see that there's a new rocking chair in my dressing room? Thank you. All right, we'll go back to the first couple of lines.
But this waiting, it means so much to us.
I know it does. But when that telegram comes, it'll mean we'll be headed for the big time. We'll be Broadway bound.
I hope you're right. The door.
I'll get it.
Telegram.
Oh. Here you are.
Thank you.
Here, I'm too nervous. You read it.
Hold it. No. Hold it.
Well, what's the matter, Jack?
Well, darling, it wasn't your fault. You were wonderful in it. Bob, it was you. I mean, for instance, get that move that you made to the door. I mean, here you are, nervously expecting a telegram that means your whole future, and you just leisurely walk to the door. Now, that's not... Here, let me show you. You were darling. You were wonderful. Now, let me show you how you do this. Miss Crowley, please. Knock on the door, please.
The door.
I'll get it. Well, anyway, you get the idea. You're supposed a little emotion there. A little action. You know what I mean? All right, now let's take it. Let's take it from the knock at the door.
I'll get it.
Ha 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 ha!
can't. You've got the knob.
All right. Now we'll take it again from that. You are just one. All right. Now take it again from the knock on the door. Now.
The door.
I'll get it.
Telegram. Oh.
Here you are.
Thank you.
Here, I'm too nervous. You read it.
Wait a minute. Hold it just a minute. It's nothing. It's nothing that you... Nothing that you kids have done. It's just that, I have to decide on something here. Now, I don't know whether it would be... Which would be better in this scene? If you grabbed the telegram away from her, or if she handed it to you. Let me think about that for a minute.
Mr. Benning.
Yes?
I think it'd be much more dramatic if he grabbed the telegram from her.
Well, yes, Wait a minute, I'm directing this. You had your chance. All right, we'll try it that way with your... I don't know, there's something bothers me. I don't know whether it's the furniture. Now, for instance, look where they got that couch. Right by it. This is ridiculous. Paula, let's move this set a little bit. This has been bothering me all the time we've been rehearsing. Bob, help me with this, would you please? I want to move this couch away from her. Right, wait a minute. And look where they got that lamp, right up there, in the way of there. Natalie, come here just a second, will you, darling? Just hold this a minute while I... That's right. Just a little bit. That's fine. Thank you, sweetheart. You see, I'm very much... You see, I want this to go real good because you may get a good job after this, you know?
Moving pictures or moving furniture?
That was good. I'll tell you what, kids, move this over to the wall. Over there by the wall. That'll be better, I think. All right. Now we'll take it again from where you're walking to the door.
I'll get it. I doubt whether this is going to work.
Yeah, that does. That is a problem there, isn't it? Let's see.
Maybe you could bring the telegram boy in through the window.
No, all of that is a thought. I'll tell you what, fellas, bring the couch back here. I think it was all right in the first place.
Didn't you think so, Miss Schultz?
Huh? I see. All right.
What's the matter with him anyway?
I don't know. Maybe he's sore at us because we didn't invite him to our wedding.
Oh, I'm sure Jack would never be sore about a thing like that.
All right. Now, come on. We'll take this scene over again from the knock on the door. Action!
The door.
I'll get it.
Telegram.
Here you are.
Thank you.
Hold it. Oh, run.
Jack.
This is awful.
What did we do wrong now, Jack?
What?
What's wrong?
It wasn't you. I was just concentrating on the messenger boys. Look, fella. Look. Here is a man eagerly waiting for a telegram. He's nervous about it, and you come in with a big smile on your face. I mean, that's not the way to do it. Come here, let me show you. Come here. I'll show you how I want this done. All right? Now, we'll take it right from the knock on the door.
The door.
I'll get it.
Telegram.
Here you are.
Thank you. Now, that's what I'm right there. Now we got it. Now that's the way I want it.
Jack, you didn't give me back the tip.
Yeah. Now the lights.
The tip.
I'm so sorry, Bob. You know, what happened was I was concentrating on the messenger boy. There you are. There you are, sir.
A dime? I gave you a quarter.
All right. Great big actor making such a fuss over a lousy 15 cents.
Look, Jack, we signed a contract to do this show, so as long as you're here, let's rehearse it and get it over with. All right?
Well, what good is rehearsing it? I mean, all you do is rehearse it, you don't give it anything. You don't play it. There's no emotion. No emotional impact. No acting.
Well, Jack, I would never claim that we did it perfectly. But I will say that perhaps there's a difference between the way that you would interpret it and the way that we would interpret it.
Oh, I see. And you feel, of course, that your interpretation is better than mine.
That's right.
Well, I'd like to ask you, kid, something. How long have you been in show business?
Well, I've been in show business for about 15 years, Jack.
Yeah.
Yes, I've been in show business about 10 years.
I see. Well, I have news for you. I've been in show business over 45 years. I guess that settles something.
The only thing that settles is his right age.
I heard that. Now listen, we're going to rehearse this scene once more. And you're going to get it right this time, or I'm just going to have to get another couple to take your place.
Wait a minute. You mean that if we don't do this scene the way you want us to do it, you'll fire us?
That's exactly what I mean. And the fact that you didn't invite me to your wedding has nothing to do with it. Now, come on. Let's get this scene and get it right. Let's get a little guts
right,
into
right,
it.
Just
a little emotion.
All right, Jack.
Come.
This is the chance we've been waiting for. This is the chance we've been waiting for.
What do you mean?
Well, if we louse it up, he'll fire us.
That'd be great.
Yeah.
All right, come on. Let's get this. Now, let's take it right from the beginning. And let's have a little acting in this. For heaven's sake. All right, action!
Why don't we hear from him? Why?
Honey, don't be so impatient. It's only 9:30.
Waiting. It means so much to us.
I know it does. But when that telegram comes, it'll mean we'll be headed for the big time. We'll be Broadway bound.
I hope you're right.
I'll get it. Telegram! There you are.
Thank you.
Here, I'm too nervous. You read it. Well, read it.
I can't.
You must.
I can't.
You must.
I can't.
When do we open? When?
Cut.
Well, that's like that, Jack.
Now you've got...
That was absolutely great. You were wonderful.
Just great. Now, I'm going to take that scene. We'll take it just the way you did it. And camera, please. Camera. I'm going to take the same scene right from the beginning, and I'll be sitting up to take a crane shot.
That's great. Now what do we do?
Well, honey, you know, we're still young yet. Maybe we can make a comeback.
All right, kid, let's take it again. Just the way you did it the first time.
Honey, we're not that young. Let's get out of here.
All right, thank you, everybody. Later. Now, come on. Action. Wait a minute. Where are you all going? Wait a minute. Let me down. I'm the director.
Jack will be back with his guest stars in just a moment, but first, here's a how-to-do-it suggestion for today. How to get the benefits of toothpaste plus mouthwash from one product. Watch.
Miss Nora Hayden, lovely star of television.
An actress has to be doubly sure of keeping her breath and teeth attractive. So I've always used both toothpaste and mouthwash. Until I discovered I get the benefits of both in this new Stripe toothpaste.
Here's why. Stripe begins with the finest white toothpaste. This will clean and polish your teeth as well as any plain white toothpaste. But now, we add the super mouthwash ingredient, hexachlorophene, the famous germ killer used by physicians and dentists. These red stripes tell you this is the hexachlorophene toothpaste stripe, which gives you the benefits of toothpaste plus mouthwash. Stripe kills tooth decay germs better than any plain white toothpaste. And Stripe kills bad breath germs even better than the best-selling mouthwash. So get the benefits of toothpaste plus mouthwash. Get Stripe.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, I'd like to bring out my guest stars. But first, I want to thank Warner Brothers for allowing Natalie Wood, the star of Cash McCall, to be on my program, and 20th Century Fox, the producers of Can-Can, for allowing Bob Wagner to appear tonight. Come on out, kids. Natalie Wood and Bob Wagner. You were both just wonderful. You know, you really were. Natalie, I hear that the two of you are in a picture together. Is that right?
Yes, that's right. It's called All the Fine Young Cannibals.
Oh, isn't that wonderful? You know something, Bob? I want to ask you. Do you ever get jealous when Natalie is in a love scene with another actor? For instance, during the scene tonight, when I kissed her all the time, were you worried about Natalie?
Well, yes, I was worried, Jack.
I thought so.
I mean, with all this flu going around.
Oh.
You might...
I just read my last line. Oh.
You mind if I say something, Jack?
No. Go right ahead.
Ladies and gentlemen, even though we did kid about it tonight, we do want you to know that we did invite Jack to our wedding. Isn't that right, Jack?
That's right. That's right. I was there.
Yes. And any time you'd like to send a present, Jack, it'll be appreciated.
Well, look, it's only been 3 years. Stop hounding me. Anyway, kids, thanks again for being on my
show.
Thanks
so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, next week be sure to watch the George Goble Show, sponsored by Stripe, the red and white toothpaste. Good night.
Next week, be sure to watch the George Goble Show with guest Don McNeil, brought to you by Stripe. The red stripes tell you this is the hexachlorophene toothpaste, Stripe, that gives you the benefits of toothpaste plus mouthwash. Jack Benny program is a J&M production, produced and directed by Seymour Burns, and written by Sam Perrin, George Balzer, Al Gordon, and Hal Goldman. Appearing on tonight's program were Harry Ellerby, Ken Peters, Roddy Bell, Glenn Turnbull, Benny Rubin, and Kip King.